Friday from Dublin.
Slanchala. I mean, cheers. This man's not from Dublin.
And his opponent from Birmingham, England, weighing at 205 pounds, the Bruiserweight, Pete Dunne!
You know, Pete Dunne's been complaining that Sheamus left the brawling brutes high and dry, took off on him, didn't give him any opportunity to expand their careers. Ridge Holland proved that argument wrong this past Tuesday night on NXT. He won the NXT Tag Team titles with Andre Chase of Chase U. So Pete Dunne, for some reason, extremely bitter over the past relationship with the Celtic Warrior Sheamus.
Yeah, and I've obviously worked with Pete Dunne and Ridge Holland. You're talking about two completely different mindsets. Pete Dunne said, you know, everything that Sheamus did was disrespectful, trying to put him down, hold him back. And he's held a grudge for a long time. And I'll tell you what, when a human like Pete Dunne holds a grudge, that thing can certainly fester.
Pete Dunne is also looking ahead to tomorrow on NXT when he battles in a triple threat match for an opportunity to become the number one contender for Ethan Page in the NXT Championship.
That's College Game Day's guest picker right there. Letting Pete Dunne know, hey, Bob, you're in for a fight here tonight. Pete Dunne's not scared of that, though, Cole.
Joe Hendry and Wes Lee also part of that triple threat match tomorrow night.
I believe in Joe Hendry, for sure.
Well, Pete Dunne doesn't. I mean, you got to wonder if Dunne is looking forward to that match tomorrow night. May overlook, as crazy as it seems, the Celtic Warrior tonight.
Yeah, you can't do that because this big fella from Dublin will,
oh,
slaughter you.
Sheamus fired up tonight. Pete Dunne has said on a number of occasions that he is here for one reason, and that is to hurt people. And he wanted to start with Sheamus. And Dunne,
ooh,
the Bruiserweight with a kick to the ear of Sheamus, and now Dunne goes on the attack. The master of joint manipulation, Pete Dunne, punishing Sheamus here.
And sometimes manipulating the joints isn't easier whenever you're fighting somebody that's bigger, but whenever you bust their hands a week before that with a shillelagh, it certainly helps.
Yeah, and again, working on the hand of Sheamus, and look at this. Pete Dunne trying to break the knuckles and the fingers of Sheamus here. And continuing to work on the arm that he attacked with the shillelagh last week. Now trying to put Sheamus into a submission position. Turns his shoulders. Yeah. Thought they were down, but robs the pot of the official is right there. And a knee right to the back, a variation of the Irish curse backbreaker by the former world champion Sheamus. Won one of his world titles just down the road from Fort Lauderdale in Miami at WrestleMania, beating Daniel Bryan in 18 seconds to win that world championship. And a kick out by Sheamus. The story of this match during the commercial break has been Pete Dunne's constant attack on the injured hand of Sheamus that Dunne took out with a shillelagh last week.
It might have been a bite of one of the fingers during the commercial break from Pete Dunne, who hates being called Butch, to Sheamus. I mean,
well, Pete Dunne said it was Sheamus who came up with that stupid nickname, Butch. Blames him for it, says it almost ruined his career. Said that Sheamus wanted the spotlight and only wanted to use Ridge and Pete Dunne as his lackeys.
Well, I don't know if you just want to toy with Sheamus. This is Sheamus' game, Pete.
Sheamus loves to brawl, loves to fight, loves to get punched in the mouth and punched back like he did there.
He's an Irishman.
Goodness, did you hear that? That sounded like somebody hit the boards here in this hockey arena.
Where are you, bitch?
Uh-oh. Oh, and a running forearm by Dunne, and now just unloading it on Sheamus.
I mean, Sheamus said, is that all you got? It sounded like it was.
I wasn't sure if he said Butch or another word that sounds like that.
Well, that might be why Pete hated it so bad, because people were calling him a little baby back Butch. And now look at him.
And now Sheamus with the axe handle, knocking Pete Dunne down. Dunne, a former tag team champion in NXT, a former NXT UK champion as well. And Sheamus now with a wicked clothesline, little payback there.
Yeah, it's almost like Pete Dunne woke up Sheamus.
And now power slam to Dunne.
Finish this thing off, Sheamus. You got to pick some games on Saturday.
Maybe you guys make it to Saturday after Friday night.
I've heard there's nothing but water over there.
And now, Pete Dunne gonna be wrapped up in the top ropes. Was looking for 10 feet to the battering, but Dunne went right back to the injured hand.
Well, he exposed the hand. The 10 feet to the battering exposes his hand, and now Pete flips it.
With his own 10 feet to Sheamus. An intense, hard-hitting Pete Dunne.
With a shrug and a smile.
This is the Pete Dunne who first burst on the scene in the NXT UK tournament a number of years ago. But Sheamus now has Dunne caught.
And this is the Sheamus that emerged on the scene 15 years ago.
They like to beat the drum here for the Florida Panthers. Sheamus is doing his own version.
Won a Stanley Cup with this method.
Well, this is a different variation of 10 beats to the battering.
That's 20 beats of the Belgium.
And he's got over 13,000. A record-breaking crowd here tonight in Fort Lauderdale on its feet.
13,718 people want to see an Irishman kick Pete Dunne's head off.
Sheamus went for the brogue and a step-up kick by Dunne. Stop Sheamus in his tracks. Pete now, second row, moonsault knee to the midsection. Cover by Sheamus, hook of the leg, and a kick out by Dunne.
I know you said midsection. I think we all know where that knee hit. And the fact that Pete Dunne kicked out, oh boy.
Right on target. And now Sheamus with Dunne on his shoulders.
It's not Christmas.
Coming up to the second rope.
We had a nutcracker and now maybe a white noise.
Well, he was looking for white noise and Dunne able to capitalize. Look at the power of Pete Dunne with a sit-out powerbomb for the win on Sheamus, who kicks out at two. Dunne can't believe it.
So I don't think Pete was able to catch that as cleanly as he would like. His legs kind of held up Sheamus, protected him a little bit. But the fact that Pete was able to powerbomb Sheamus.
At 270 pounds, Dunne walking around the ring with.
Lord is right.
Indeed it is. What a way to kick off Monday Night Raw tonight. Two of the best in the world going at it. And now Pete Dunne trying to trap Sheamus's bad hand inside the turnbuckle pad.
What the?
Sheamus might as well be handcuffed. His bad hand caught in the turnbuckle pad.
How is this illegal?
Sheamus is a sitting duck. Kick right to the bad hand of Sheamus. Sheamus trying to somehow pull the whole turnbuckle off. Brown kick by Sheamus. Cover. And a win.
Here is your winner, Sheamus.
What a match.
What a fight.